Hello YouTubers. Okay, so this video is kind of mainly for myself really, but if it does add any value to someone else who's kind of intrigued to see a couple of things. For one, just to see the movement which is obtained by my little DIY camera boom slash jig. The other thing is I'm going to upload this video about 6 times and change the resolution and the format just to see what posts best to YouTube for myself. I'm looking for good detail on subject matter here on the desk, so that's what I'm going to test, is kind of the color and the detail that can be picked up when I zoom in. You'll note that the light at the moment, I need to build a diffuser for the light. If I come over, you can see the light reflection over there, so I need to deal with that, but we will work with that for this test. So we're going to do this internal test. I'm also going to do a shot outside. So this basically is the movement which I can do with this jig I've got set together. I'm just going to go over this watch and zoom in a little bit. Just keen to see what kind of detail and the resolution we can pick up with the camera like this. I know the camera will, the focus will go out at some point in time. What I'm keen to pick up is to see the pixelation, like for instance on that second hand that's ticking around with any movement. So I'll bring the zoom back out. Have a look at the second watch. Have a look at the face. See the level of detail we can get. Come out again. Then move on to the multimeters. Come up again. There we go. Now I'm raising the boom. I'm not doing a zoom now. I'm just raising the boom to get a overall overhead shot. Okay, this camera does have a macro mode as well, which I'm just going to test now. So I'm going to come down to the watch and then see how close I can zoom in. Particularly, I'm trying to see that writing. I'm going to take my hand off the camera. Just let it settle because it is See if we can get any closer. Take the camera across. Okay, so this camera also has a tele macro zoom function. The camera is roughly 1.5 feet off the work area at the moment. And for instance, I intend to do watch reviews. And the one thing that's difficult to see is obviously the writing on the back of the watch. Now, unfortunately, the function doesn't seem to work when the camera is actually running. So I'll stop the camera and we'll flip to when it's actually zoomed down into the zoom. So there you go. That's literally the camera still a foot and a half up. I should be able to zoom out from this point, but you can quite obviously clearly see the number. And as long as I don't bump everything, because it's quite super zoomed, I'm going to try and come up from that. There you go. Okay, so here's one last test of that telemacro zoom function. Again, the camera's still up high. I'm just going to move the watch myself, so I'm keen to see the definition and what have you, which is showing up. See what it looks like with the hand ticking. Just keen to see if we can see that writing that's there. I'll get my hands off the desk so we get it a still shot. And then we'll zoom out. Okay. The next shot we'll do will be an outside shot to see how that shows up under high resolution. Okay, so here's a shot outdoors. Just keen to see how this shows up in the different resolutions. That's at full zoom. That's all optical, no digital. It's all handheld, no tripod, and fortunately the image stability actually does help a fair bit with these shots. Okay, that just about finishes it up. I say this is mainly for me to check what the quality looks like on YouTube, but if this footage does help others in any way, then that's great. And again, if you do enjoy the channel, then please do subscribe. Cheers.